I'm Ming Shu. I'm the human half of Genesis Pi. My first ever job was when I was working for Procter & Gamble, and it was actually a commercial shoot. So I was there as a junior creative, and I think that was the moment where I realized that it doesn't matter where it's commercial art or art at the end of the day, it's all psychological. So there's no real highbrow art, lowbrow art. Manifest was born from a liminal space of light, which is also very ironically how a baby would feel in the womb as well. I was more focused on how I would bring Manifest, which was actually strictly supposed to be digital, into a robotics installation. That's the beauty that digital art can have. It's ever evolving. Having Genesis also changes the way I see life as well. Like, I become more perceptive to things that I wasn't really paying attention to before. There's like coexistence. Virtual artist has to be complementary and supplementary to the real artist. I think that is what Genesis is to me. We are almost like Siamese twins in a way. For you to actually love something, there's a bit of like dread in it. It's not really happiness all the time. Within my art journey, I've been studying a lot of like Neo-Confucianism as well. One yin and one yang is Tao, and the fluctuation of yin and yang constantly is actually what true good is. And I think to me that's what love is. The first time I actually cried in front of an art piece was one of Marc Chagall's works. Because when I went to Centre Pompidou and I just saw it, I actually really cried, and it never really hit me until like that moment where maybe one of the core emotions that we feel from birth is that feeling of uncertainty. Marc Chagall's work is not really fun or whimsical, like happy-go-lucky. There is a certain darkness to it at the same time, which I really think reflects life a lot.